One of the common problems in Unreal Engine is that you brought sunlight into the scene and moving around the scene, suddenly you start realizing shadow of the object start disappearing. There are many underlying causes of this. I'll try to demystify this based on the type of shadowing method you are using right now. From my understanding, there should be three possible scenarios that you are in. The first one is OG traditional shadowing. To be in that stage, make sure in your project setting, type ray, turn off ray trace shadow. And let's bring in directional light into the scene, go to lit mode, rotate a little bit. And if you go further away, yeah, the shadows start disappearing. To fix this, click the directional light, go to the detail panel, scroll down a little bit, uncheck distance field shadow. We're gonna check this one back, but just to make it easier to understand, uncheck this one and reduce dynamic shadow distance, and you suddenly start to see the shadow distance start changing. So you can simply just set crazy number on this one, like 500,000, and shadow no longer disappears. Although it starts to get blurry as you go further away. Reverting back to 40,000, so you have a clipping already happening. Check this one back, distance field shadow. What happened right now is after 40,000 of OG shadow, distance field shadow start to kick in. You can start increasing these values to fill in distance field shadow. You may see distance field shadow clipped already like this, but you can fix that from here. So it's just a balance, like how much you want to use OG shadow and how much you want to use distance field shadow. You can play around from here, but it's kind of not nice. You can kind of see the transition. So if you don't like this method, there's a second method to go with it. So let's revert these back. So the second method is to use virtual shadow map. So go to project settings and type in shadow and make sure shadow map method is using virtual shadow map, or else from console variable type r.shadow.virtual.enable1. So supposedly virtual shadow map is better version of OG shadow map. You will still see some clipping issue. It's because virtual shadow map heavily relies on nanite. So we're gonna turn on nanite on this guy here. This is the source mesh. So we're gonna turn on nanite. So voila, we no longer see the shadow clipping anymore. And for whatever reason, you don't wanna use nanite for your mesh. So we're gonna revert this one back. You don't wanna use nanite, but you don't want clipping. In that case, click the mesh in the detail panel, search bound, and increase the bound scale. So that shadowing gets better. From certain point, maybe you will start clipping, so you can increase more. And it's a little bit performance heavy apparently, but in case if you don't wanna turn on nanite, this is another way to go with it. So this is the virtual shadow method. The last method is using ray trace shadow. It's not path tracing, it's ray tracing shadow. To do it, go back to project settings, type shadow, ray trace shadow is checked, type ray, and also hardware ray tracing, software ray tracing, you know, anything related to ray tracing is on. And go back to directional light. Also, we have to tell directional light to use ray trace shadow. So we type in ray. If it says project settings, it's okay, or you can use ray trace trace shadow enabled, and now it's using ray trace shadow. Before that, make sure to set these bound size back to 1. So yeah, as you can see from ray tracing, bound size also affects, so you can increase bound to prevent the clipping also happening. One different thing from virtual shadow map is you cannot use nanite for this to fix it. Nanite still cause this shadow clipping issue, so you can increase bound to prevent this one. But if it's annoying to increase the bound of each static mesh in the scene, you can go console variable, type r.raytracing.culling. You can set this one to 0. so that the shadow will no longer ever going to be cold. So this is how you're going to fix when you're using ray tracing. Thank you so much for chiming in, everyone. Hope to see you soon in the next video. Bye!